This one is the sun-in rigid hone, which is kind of awesome. These stones come out exactly parallel to each other, so it will take a tapered cylinder and make it not tapered anymore. But in doing so, it tends to make the cylinder larger, which may not be what you want. This is usually done after you've bored the engine block and you want perfect, absolutely cylindrical, perfect cylinders. Cylindrical cylinders, that's how we roll. Looks like this, very common, easy to use, and I usually have students use these for their practice engines, but if they're doing an engine that they're going to use for themselves, I have them use this one, which I call a ball hone. Some people also call it a dingleberry, which is kind of funny. This one gives you a really nice surface finish on it, so it's kind of handy. For all of these, you're going to need to use a drill and something to hone it with. I often use WD-40. I've used automatic transmission oil. I've used solvent. I've used proper honing oil. You need something to flush the stuff away and give you a nice finish. I'm going to put a cookie sheet underneath the motor to catch all the dribblings. That way I don't have to clean the floor. When you hone a cylinder, you want to have the crosshatch pattern going about like this. If you're looking at horizontal, it's going to be about 30 degrees or so. And this gives you a nice pattern. It holds the right amount of oil. It helps the rings seat in nicely. And this kind of a pattern put into the cylinder helps the engine brake in a lot better. Without honing the cylinders, you're putting fresh rings onto a polished, smooth cylinder, and those new rings will never break in, they'll never bed into the cylinder, and they'll never seal. So we need to hone it and get this kind of pattern. If you stroke the cylinder too quickly, you'll get a crosshatch pattern like this. And this isn't going to work very well for your rings. You need to have the right pattern, and this is not it. I guess I put an X in there. If you spin the drill too quickly, you get a crosshatch pattern that looks like this. So somehow you need to have the right spinning speed and the right stroking speed, and somewhere in there it will be happiness and it'll give you the pattern you want. Okay, we're going to stroke this and spin this, and when I'm done, I'm going to pull this out in one path, like this. And then pull it out in one go. When you're honing, you want to watch out for these. If you hit these with the honing stone, you will shatter the stones and ruin it. So don't do that. Don't pull it out like this. No. Ah. That's kind of what the crosshatch pattern should look like. Not sure how visible that is on the camera, but we want to have a notable angle. Let's go over to one that a student did. Not bad. Some of it looks pretty good, but it looks like he was inconsistent in the stroke. And if you look over here, they stopped the hone and then dragged it all the way up the cylinder. So congratulations, you just ruined all of your work. Now you got to do it again.